Thanks for tuning in to Show Me the Nuggets. With the Board of Trinidad here from the team at Digital Triggers. We've got a quick fire follow-up to last week's interview with Mike Gore-Hickman today. In this bite-sized episode, Mike's going to share a two-step sales process that he uses to close about 45% of his calls. And he's also going to dig into why inbound marketing is the way to go if you want to have an easier time with your sales appointments. Let's dive in.
My team, Eduardo, reached out to you and asked, what's something cool that you could share that would be valuable for all the podcast listeners? You said that you could share your sales call kind of template or checklist or your process that you take people through.
Yeah. So there's two types of sales calls, and not every sales call is the same. So you got to, when you're going into your sales process, you want to know if you're going to be doing call A or call B, call type A or call type B. And so we'll start with A, and this is the two-step sales process. I find most new agency owners or even existing agency owners are more comfortable with this two-step sales process because it's lower pressure for the client. It's a lot more conversational, and you can still get a really great close rate for this two-step process. Sorry, the third reason why it's actually really great is because when you're setting the expectation for people to book this call, all they're committing to is like a 10 to 15 minute chat with you. So to get someone to commit to a 10, 15 minute chat with you about their business versus getting them to commit to an hour long presentation is a completely different threshold. So if you can decrease that threshold on the front end and get more people to book, that's going to allow you to have more great conversations and more sales calls. But basically this first call is, you know, introduction. Hey, how's it going? What motivated you to hop on the call with me today? So you kind of get, you know, get their intention. And a really important thing as they start talking is you need to have Notepad open and you need to write down what they're saying, or you need to be recording the call, right? You need to think, you need to listen to the needs, the wants, the desires, the specifics that they're saying in order for this whole process to work. So, hey, what motivated you to hop on the call? From there, you're just going to say, you're going to do a quick introduction. So how I do my introduction is like, okay, well, here's how I run the call. First, I'm just going to ask you a few questions about your business just to see if this is a potential fit. I'm going to give you a quick overview of my solution and what I think I might be able to do for you, if anything. And if you like what you hear, then we're going to set up another meeting where I'm going to take you through it in more detail. How does that sound? Okay, so you're setting the expectation and getting them to already commit to a second meeting. Cool. So now it's really vital that you start asking them really good, thoughtful questions about their business. And these aren't difficult. It's like, hey, tell me about your business. What are your biggest challenges? What are your goals? What's preventing you from getting those goals right now? You know, what if you're selling at digital marketing services, what have you tried for marketing in the past? Right? Did it work? Did it not work? What did you like about it? What did you not like about it? Once they give you the answer to those questions, now what we call is like the transition or the pivot. And this is like mission critical. You need to be absolutely confident with this next step. You need to say, wow, based on everything that you've said so far, you are an absolute perfect fit for my program. Can I tell you a little bit about it? And then we can schedule that second meeting to learn a bit more. So you're telling them that they're in a perfect fit. And now with the notes that you've taken from that initial discovery, you're going to be pivoting the second part of your presentation. So what I do, my solution is going to help you get solve this problem, that problem, that problem, the ones that they stated before. And we're going to do that with this proprietary marketing method that does this, this, and this, right? And it does it without these issues, the problems that they had from their previous marketing experience, right? If they had any. So the entire second part of the call where you're explaining your services, you're taking in the words that they used on you and you're saying it back to them. It's going to sound absolutely perfect to them. It's like, okay, this sounds really great. Now, here's where you can make one of two decisions. You can decide if you want to price drop at this point. So we can definitely solve that problem. You know, my fees typically start at about $1,000 per month or whatever your fees are. But if that's the case, then you're going to get, you know, this many clients or that many clients. With that being said, can we still go ahead and schedule that second call? Right. So you're getting that commitment. You're kind of dropping that price, or it's, you know, my pricing is between this and between that. Right. So they can kind of get an idea so that by the second call, they're going to be ready to make a decision because we want that decision on that second call. Right.
Yep.
The upside is that you might get that decision. The downside is they might say no. And then, you know what? That's actually an upside because you save your second call time. And then that's really how I structure the first call. And then the second call is you put together a deck. you take the information that they gave you, you put it into the first few slides to show that you were listening, and really you structure your presentation around the information that they gave you, and give them projections, pricing, and then you should accept all forms of major credit card payment.
Yeah, so great. You want to get started with Visa or MasterCard, sir? Dude, that was great. Even without the notes in front of you, you can tell that you know the system so well. You've ran so many demos. You've ran so many of these appointments. Because I'm looking at Eduardo's notes and I'm like, yeah, like he just went through all of those like off the top of his head. That's awesome, man. I love how you drop the barrier to entry, right? We're running a funnel right now. We costs are way too high. We dropped the barrier to entry. In just one example, and the cost dropped in half for the same result. And so I love that you said that. I actually wrote that down, is to drop that barrier of entry. And I love that it was just, it's a 15 minute call, right? So it's super simple. It's not a huge commitment. You're not also telling somebody to sign up to get pitched. Like, sign up, we'll see if it's a fit in 15 minutes. Like, that's really easy to say yes to. And then I love like your question, like just great, you're here. You obviously signed up for a reason. Like that's basically what you're saying. Why are you here? Right? Like, what do you need? Like what motivated you to use your words? What motivated you to sign up for this call? So then you're going to figure out what all their desires are, their wants are, and then you have everything that you need to really make a sale happen either there or on the two step.
Totally. And now I did promise the one step. So I'll give a quick overview of that and how it's different. And also okay. I want you to remind me to talk about the difference between inbound appointments and outbound appointments after. Okay. The one step process, the main difference is, okay, you have like 30 to 60 minutes with the prospect. And now you have 30 to 60 minutes to understand their needs, convey the messaging, pitch your product and get a commitment. So it's a much more difficult task. And I don't do many of these anymore because it is a little bit more pressure for the client. They, you know, you want them to make a decision and you need to really employ a lot more of like the traditional like Zig Ziglar, style of, objection handling and things like that on this one step process than you do on the two step process. So, the one step process at the start, you're going to start the exact same way. What motivated you? What types of issues are you having in your business right now? What are your goals? What are the barriers that you've encountered in terms of not being able to hit those goals? Where do you want to be in the next year? What's preventing you from hitting that goal? What type of marketing you've done in the past? Things like that. Okay. Then we have the first transition, which is going to be the exact same, like we said before. Wow, this is a perfect fit. So excited to work with you for this, and this reason. Mind if we jump into it? Getting permission. Okay. Then you go to the next step, which is it's going to be your presentation. Now in this style, because you have a cut and paste presentation, you haven't had time to customize it. You're going to have had written down all of the specific terms that they used in that first part and just pepper them into your language as you go. Right. This is really important to do. And if you just start going on autopilot and just go through your deck as you normally do, you're going to wonder why your sales rate is absolutely dropping. I mean, I've gotten that. I've gotten in sales slumps in the past. And it always comes back to just going on autopilot, not customizing the presentation for the client. And then, of course, when you get to like your proposal is going to obviously be more not customized. What's the opposite? Like,
yep.
More not can. Customized yep. for the customer. And they're going to know that. Because it's already going to be there. It's already going to be in. The pricing is going to be filled in and everything before you even got their needs. So you're running into some problems like that, that I probably, that are more difficult, but again, are not possible to overcome if you are solving one thing for one set of people, right?
Yep.
So that's kind of like how I would run that. And then, we can talk about closing theory for hours and hours. We're not going to get into that today, but I would say go with the two step for sure right now.
Okay. So start with the two step. And then in terms of like KPIs, where should somebody's goals be? Like, what would you tell them? Like, what are your goals in terms of what percentage do you close or how do you hold yourself accountable to the numbers? What are the KPIs that you track?
KPIs that I track versus KPIs that I recommend are different depending on what you're selling and the cost of those services.
Yeah.
So my KPI, like my absolute, high, like threshold KPI for cost of acquisition is $1,500, right? Yep. I don't want to spend more than $1,500 to acquire a client. And then I work backwards. My sales rate is about 45% on inbound. So that's wow. Just over 1 in 2, but let's say it's 1 in 3. So that's $500 per appointment. That's what I can realistically, I've been at my threshold, I can withstand to pay up to $500 per appointment. I mean, I'm typically seeing kind of between like $100 to $150 per appointment. So it's way more profitable than that, but I know what my threshold is. And I would just ask you, you know, as a listener, that question, what is your threshold and what is your sales rate? And therefore, what are you willing to spend per appointment? Because really this whole scalability thing is it all boils down to, can you get appointments on demand? And can you reliably close those appointments in a customer's? Those are the two things.
Yep. And retention. I mean, that's it. That's your business, right? Those three major things, and you have your business in a nutshell. That makes perfect sense. So you said to remind you about inbound versus outbound.
Totally. So when I say inbound versus outbound, I mean, are you doing outbound prospecting activities to get appointments? Like, are you doing, you know, LinkedIn outreach? Are you doing messaging? Are you doing whatever? Are you doing outbound activities to get appointments, right? And if you are, then your sales conversation is going to be a lot different because the person you're talking to is going to have their guard up a lot more than if you were doing inbound prospecting, right? So I always recommend, like, if you want to have easier conversations and easier sales appointments, do inbound marketing. So this is when you do paid ads, you provide value, you provide like a funnel for ideal customers to go through to book appointments on your calendar so that when you talk to them, you can say, all right, what brought you here? And then they're going to start telling you about their business. Instead of on the outbound model, you can say, hey, why'd you schedule this call with me today? Well, I scheduled this call with you today because you messaged me 18 times in the last 24 hours. Right. So it's a different call dynamic. And really you're not sitting in the driver's seat on outbound prospecting sales calls.
Yeah, I completely agree. I've done a lot of outbound. I've done a lot of one call closes, and we just found like we had to do one calls with outbound because it was like, they'd ignore us. They'd be gone. We had to pitch them while we had them, or things kind of fell apart. So huge difference, definitely, in the prospect's attention, willingness to listen, willingness to get on multiple follow-ups. Just the attention is much different for sure. I'm glad that you brought that up. And KPIs should be different then as well. It'll be cheaper probably to get appointments, but they're not going to convert probably as well. That's a good point.
Thanks for tuning in to Show Me the Nuggets. If you've been enjoying the podcast and find our content helpful, please visit our Apple Podcast page, hit the subscribe button, and leave us a review. Joe and the whole team have been working hard to bring more value to the show. Your feedback will go a long way in helping us make the show better and reach a wider audience.